I've seen horrors. I've seen the horrors that you've seen. You have no right to call me a murderer. You have the right to kill me. You have that right. But you do not have the right to judge me. Words can't describe what's necessary to those who don't know what horror means. Horror has a face. And you must make a friend of horror. Horror and moral terror are your friends. If they are not, then they are enemies to be feared. They are truly enemies. I remember when I was in the Special Forces, seems like 1,000 centuries ago. We had come to a camp to inoculate the children. And we left the camp after we had inoculated the children for polio. And an old man came running after us. He was crying. He couldn't say. We went back there. And they had come and hacked off every inoculated arm. There they were in a pile. A pile of little arms. And I remember I cried. I wept like some grandmother. I wanted to tear my teeth out. I didn't know what I wanted to do. And I want to remember. I don't ever want to forget. And then I realized, like I was shot with a diamond bullet through my forehead. I thought, my God, the genius of that. Genius. The will to do that. Perfect. Complete. Genuine, crystalline, pure. And I realized then that they were stronger than we, because they could stand that. These men were not monsters. Trained cadres who fought with their hearts, who had families, had children, filled with love. But they had the strength. The strength to do that. If I had 10 divisions of those men, our troubles here would be over very quickly. You need moral men, but they must also be able to utilize their primordial instinct to kill without feeling, without passion, without judgment, without judgment. Because judgment is what defeats us.